Guys, this is ridiculous fight commentary breakdowns, by the way. So, it turns out our new Dim Mak Wing Chun Master LuGang that got beat by Xu Xiaodong recently, he has a similar excuse to the other Wing Chun Masters that Xu Xiaodong beat. Instead of saying he wasn't fed well during the fight or right before the fight, he says he's chronically malnourished. According to Wing Chun Master, our Dim Mak God, he says he only eats about 20 meals per month. On top of that, very crucial, he blames his vegetarianism. He's like, oh, it's all vegetarianism's fault. I'm too skinny. I didn't have enough mass, didn't have enough force to fight Xu. So it's not his lack of skill, not the fact that Wing Chun, all that technique, was supposed to overcome Xu Xiaodong's pandaness, but it's now he's blaming his size and food. See, it's part of Chinese culture. They always blame food, man. Whenever you go anywhere, it's about the food. Whenever something goes wrong, it's always about the food. But the reason I wanted to make this video is to call out our Wing Chun Master, because before the fight, he said very clearly he could beat our MMA Panda because he punched harder. Yes, our Wing Chun Master claimed that he punched harder. So it seemed like before the fight, he didn't think his size, his skinniness, was going to play a difference. But now that he lost, it's about his size and the fact that he's a vegetarian. Our Wing Chun Master also claimed before the fight, one, wo de shu du geng kuai. So he claimed his speed was quicker. 他跟不上我的节奏. So he's saying our MMA Panda can't follow the rhythm of the fight that our Wing Chun Master laid out. Second, 我的技术比他还好, or 比他好太多. So basically, what our Wing Chun Master is saying is he's much more skilled than MMA Panda Winter Melon. Number three, he claimed 我的拳比他重. In other words, he punched harder. And number four, he said 我的灵活性, I'm more flexible. So all of that was proven false by the fight. Also, he mentioned that, you know, now we're talking about the Dim Mak, right? The Dim Mak, the Dim Xue. By the way, for those of you who didn't know, Pressure Point, aka Dim Mak. So he was using Dim Mak Wing Chun. He says, quote, my Dim Mak has become part of me. But then it's like just completely part of him. Shan Dian Ban, it's like lightning speed. It'll just come out. That's what he says. Just like Bruce Lee. He actually compares himself to Bruce Lee. Just like Bruce Lee's kind of no move, Jeet Kune Do. A lot of times my Dim Mak, I don't even know what I'm going to throw. So it just becomes part of me. It's part of my fundamentals. I don't have any specific moves. But of course, you lose the fight and it's all about the food. Okay, fight commentary breakdowns. For those of you watching, if you haven't seen the fight, you can watch it here or I'll just put it over my narration. And thank you guys so much for watching. We will see each other soon. Bye-bye. And shout out to all the news media that have featured this craziness. Love you guys. And leave your comments. Looking forward to hearing your thoughts. Bye-bye.
Here they go. Look at our Winter Melon Panda. Let's call him Winter Melon Panda. He is so angry. Look at that forward pressure. At first, it looked like the Wing Chun guy had a little bit of a lateral step, but the moment he got hit in the face, he just lost it. And it's still adrenaline at this point. He still thinks he's got it, and none of the pressure points, none of the trapping is working, none of the grabbing. So he still thinks he's got it, but you can tell he's a little slower now, right? He's concussed. And now, look at this, clinch fighting, just absolute battering, man. By the way, in case you guys didn't see the previous video, our MMA Panda has 100 pounds. 100 pounds on our guy. Look at this. Oh, my goodness. Just working the uppercut. And that left just took him out. And then the ref's like, okay, that's enough.